figuring out how your DNA matches are related to you can be a little bit daunting. And it actually involves a lot of math. But you don't have to do the math, necessarily. A lot of that math has been done for you. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and today we're going to talk about the Relationship Probabilities tool on GEDmatch. If you've been doing genetic genealogy for any amount of time, you know that you get half of your DNA from your parents, approximately a quarter from each one of your grandparents, and so on as you go up through your ancestors. All of that ends up adding into probabilities of how you might be related to other people based on the amount of shared DNA. On GEDmatch, this tool is found on the Tier 1. You have to be a Tier 1 member, and it is in the one-to-many full version. First, we need to enter a kit number. I'm going to enter one of mine, and we have the results here. Now, I've slid over to show where this is. So what I am looking at is I'm looking under the autosomal column. You have three columns, the total CM, the largest CM, and the generations. The probability tool is in the total CM column. You can see that each one of these is linked, and that will open up the probabilities. When I click on one of them, I'm going to have this probability list, and it's going to go through and tell me what the probability is of this person being different relationships. So for instance, you can see this one had 1,763 total shared CM, which is one of the quarter relationships. And that includes half siblings, aunts, uncles, nieces, and nephews, grandparent, grandchild, and great grandparent, great grandchild in a small little bit. Additionally, this is actually divided up into the maternal and the paternal side. So you can see that when it's looking at a half sibling, well, it's more likely to be on the maternal side than on the paternal side. As far as aunt, uncle, it's almost even as far as the maternal or paternal half aunt and uncle. And grandparent, it again, there's a little bit of a difference between the maternal and the paternal side. Overall though, you'll notice that the difference between the low one here, 12.7%, and the high, 19.1%, is not that great. In other words, there's pretty equal chance it could be any one of these based simply on the amount of shared DNA. So what the idea behind this tool is it's to give you a clue of where to start your search. In other words, start with the highest probability, and as you can eliminate those, then you can start looking at the others. Let's go and take a look at some ones that are not as much DNA. So here's what match shares 400 centimorgans. I click on that and you'll notice that there's actually a lot more groups here. Now, when it talks about a group, for instance, a first cousin once removed group, it's talking about that amount of shared DNA. The only relationship in that group is a first cousin once removed. If we go down to this next group, a half first cousin group, you may be thinking, okay, so I should be looking at just half first cousins. Well, no, you should be looking at half first cousins, but you should also be looking at half grand aunts, grand uncles, grand nieces, grand nephews. They share that same amount of DNA as that half first cousin. If we go to the second cousin group, it's not just second cousins, but it's also first cousins twice removed. It's also half first cousins once removed. So the half first cousin group does not contain that half first cousin once removed. It contains that second cousin group. Now there's been different people that have named these groups in different ways. Some have just used letters, the group A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Others have used some nomenclature like this. Because of the multiple different relationships, it's kind of hard to have just a name that everybody can agree on. And it's not always intuitive. For instance, let's just take a look at this second cousin once removed group. We have second cousin once removed, half second cousins, half first cousin twice removed, and first cousin three times removed. Those all share the same amount of DNA as the second cousin once removed group. Again, when we look at probabilities, we can see that they vary. In this case, it's always listed from the most down to the least in these groups. 35.5%, a little over a third, is the probability that this is a first cousin once removed. Being in the second cousin once removed group, it's only a 1.8% probability. So it is much more likely that it is one of these first three groups than it is one of these other lower groups. Now, this data has been compiled by a man named Britt Nicholson. You can click on the link and read about his methodology in this blog post here. Some of the graphs may look somewhat similar because of how the data was created. So if you have looked at Ancestry and they've shown you some relationship prediction, they might have some of these graphs in their white paper. Likewise, the Shared CM tool has some relationship prediction, and it uses similar, although different, data sets. And so one of the things in comparing Ancestry and Shared CM tool and this relationship probabilities on GEDmatch, they're gonna be slightly different. And that's just because they've used different data sets. Why they don't just all use the same data set is because it's actually good to have some different algorithms to be able to compare. One of the things you see between the three of them, if you put in the same amount of shared centimorgans, it's going to come up with the same groups, just the probabilities are going to be off by maybe 1% or 2% between different things. But this is a great tool whenever you're wondering, okay, how is this match related to me? So I have this match here. I have no idea who they are, where they're from on my family tree. Well, the first thing I can do is click on this and be given this task of where all these different relationships may be. Smaller amount of DNA that you share, the more groups you're going to end up having. In this case, with a 400 centimorgan, there was what, 6 groups, and really only 3 of them were major groups. Well, now I clicked on one that is 50 centimorgans, and you can see that there are 10 groups, and actually all of them are somewhat evenly matched in percentages. There's obviously these topmost groups are more by about 3 times than the bottommost groups, but it's not going from 30% to these bottom groups being 0.2% or 1%. And this is one of the reasons why when you just have a single match that you don't know, that say is 30 or 40 centimorgans, you can't really tell how they're related to you just from that amount of centimorgans, because look at all these different relationships they could possibly be. A third cousin, but really a second cousin, because there's some second cousins that are part of this group, all the way down to 7th cousins. So there's 5 generations of difference between that. That is possible. So again, that tool is only available to Tier 1 members on GEDmatch, but it is embedded into the One-to-Many tool. Now be sure to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. If you want to join FHF Extra, it's only $2.99 a month, and that helps us to continue this channel going.